Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will study what is virtual function and polymorphism. Polymorphism is an ability to take more than one form. It means, suppose if I am talking about the plus operator, then plus operator can be used as an addition operator also, and it can be used as concatenation operator also. So when I use my plus operator in the case of numbers, I called it as addition operator, whereas when I use my plus operator with the help of string, then I called it as concatenation operator. So it means my plus operator has more than one form. So in this video we will discuss how actually the polymorphism is implemented with the help of programs. Polymorphism comes under a two type. That is, there are two types of polymorphism. Number one is called as compile time polymorphism, and the two is called as runtime polymorphism. In the compile time polymorphism, there are two types, function overloading and operator overloading. What is function overloading? That we have already studied. When we use a function more than once in a program with the same name but with the different number of parameters. So basically my function name will remain the same but your signature will be a different at every place. Then I called it as function overloading, because in this case your compiler invokes the correct function by matching the parameters or by matching the types of parameter you are using. Then I called it as function overloading, and this information is known to the compiler at the compile time. At the compile time, compiler decides which function to invoke, hence it is called as compile time polymorphism. Then there is one more type of overloading, that is operator overloading. Operator overloading, when I use my operators with the user defined data type in the same way I used with the built-in data type, then I called it as operator overloading. This concept also we have already discussed in the previous video. So these two types comes under the category of compile time polymorphism. Now what is runtime polymorphism? There comes a situation where your function name and parameters both are same. Then I called it as runtime polymorphism, because in this case compiler get confused which function to call, because your function name and parameter, I mean your function name and signature, everything will be same at the every place. So to implement this concept, I use a feature called as virtual function. So let us have a look onto a virtual function. Now see this example. In this case, I have created a two class, that is class A and class B. If you will see here, class A has a function whose name is void show, and class B again has a function whose name is void show. Now in both the cases, the prototype is same and the function name is also same. So in this case your compiler will get confused, and by default it will keep on calling your function which is there inside the base class. But I don't want this. I want the functions which is there in the derived class also to get called. So for this I will use a concept called as virtual function. Now to study a virtual function, I have an example. We will see that example and then we will understand how to use a virtual function. In this example, I have created a class base. In this class base, I have created two functions, that is void display and void show. As of now, you just forget about what is virtual. You concentrate on only these two functions, that is void display and void show. In the void display, you are displaying display base, and in the void show, you are displaying show base. Then I created one more class, that is class derive, and this class derive is a derived class of your class base. In this, again, there are two functions, display and show. In this, you are displaying display derive, and in this, you are displaying show derive. Now, in this case, my prototype of display and show is same in your class base also and your class derive also. Now in this case, by default only the functions which are there in the base class that will get called. It means you won't get answer of the function which are there in the derive class. So to get the answer of those functions also, what I will do, I will create objects of both the classes, that is class B and class D, and then you will create a pointer to a base class. So basically what I did here, I created an object B, then I created object D, and then I created a pointer, and this pointer is a pointer to class base. Now when your pointer base is pointing to a base class, it means what? You are calling the functions which are there in the base class. And when your pointer is pointing to a derived class, then it means what? You are calling to a functions which are there in the derived class. But by default you will get an answer of only a base class. So to get the answer of derived class, what I will do, I will use a keyword called as virtual in place of base class. I mean, wherever there are the functions whose name is same as a function in the derived class, I will make those function as a virtual function in the base class. So when I make them as a virtual, what will happen? When my base pointer is pointing to a base, you will get an answer of the base class. And when your base pointer is pointing to a derived, you will get an answer of derived class. So that is the use of virtual function. If you don't make it as virtual, then by default, you will keep on getting the answer of base class. So hence, it is necessary to use the virtual keyword whenever I want the answer of base class also and I need the answer of derived class. So this is the example of what? Virtual function. What we have studied here, there are two types of polymorphism, compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. Now this question is very important as per your exam view, because this question comes either for 4 marks or for 3 marks. If it comes for 4 marks, then explanation along with the program is needed. If it comes for 3 marks, then explanation along with the example is needed. That is, you have to show what is compile time polymorphism and what is runtime polymorphism, both. Now there are some rules for the virtual function. Number one, a virtual function must be a member of some class. That is, if you are using a virtual function, then obviously it should be a member of some class. They cannot be a static member. Your virtual function cannot be a static member. Number three, they are accessed by using object pointer. So if you will remember in the example what I did, I created a pointer to a base class. Without creating a pointer, you cannot access your virtual function. So that's why it is necessary to create a pointer of a base class. Next, a virtual function can be a friend of another class. Yes, you can create a virtual function and that virtual function can be a friend of some other class. A virtual function in base class must be defined even though it is not used. It means what? So in the previous example, I had taken two functions, that is display and show. Even though you are not making a use of display and show, you have to make it as virtual. Why to make it as virtual? To get the answer of derived class. If you won't make it as virtual, you won't be getting an answer of derived class. So that's why it is necessary to make it as virtual even though if it is not in the use. The prototype of the base class version and the derived class version should be same. Obviously, if the prototype is different, then I won't consider it as a runtime polymorphism. Then it will go inside the category of what? Function overloading. So that's why your prototype should be same in the case of base class and in the derived class. Next is, we cannot have a virtual constructor, but yes, we can have a virtual destructor. Next, a base pointer can point to any type of derived object, but reverse is not true. Your base class can point to any type of derived object, but the reverse is not true. It means you cannot create a pointer to a derived class and that pointer cannot point to any base class. So it means while creating a pointer, you have to be very sure that you are creating a pointer of only base class. When base pointer points to a derived class, incrementation and decrementation is only relative to its base type. Virtual function defined in the base class need not be redefined in the derived class. So it means what? The function which are there in the derived class, we don't make them as a virtual. Only the functions of the base class are treated as a virtual function. So this was all about the virtual function and the runtime polymorphism. Thanks for watching this video. In the next video, we will study what is files. For the latest video, please subscribe the channel Ekeeda.